I'd like to begin by giving you a brief overview of a typical manual AP process that you might be familiar with if you look at your process that you're doing now around invoice approval. And then I'll give you a brief description of how we can help reduce the time taken to perform those manual tasks and how we can improve visibility and then therefore control over where your invoices are at any one moment in time within the AP team. And then I'm going to jump straight into the software presentation and show you the interfaces and walk you step by step through the life cycle of an invoice once it's uploaded into our solution, right through to posting into the ERP system for payment. So typically, in the manual process, invoices come in via post and the post is opened, and obviously you've got paper invoices. Companies also receive invoices via email electronically. And in many cases, the first step is to print off those invoices so you've got a physical paper copy. Someone in the accounts team is then responsible for doing manual data entry and keying that information from the page into the ERP system, okay, so logging it on the system. And then they're responsible for coding the invoice. So which cost center and nominal code does this invoice need to be coded against when it goes into the ERP system? If necessary, you might need to require physical sign-off of an invoice before it can be paid. So quite often that involves taking the physical piece of paper around your organization, giving it to somebody to physically sign before it can be paid. Now, that has its own problems in itself because not everybody is office-based, particularly these days, and offices tend to sit on people's desks for extended periods of time. Perhaps they might get lost, they fall off people's desks, they get put into drawers, you get extra paperwork put on top of them. It's very hard for the AP team to keep track of which invoices they've assigned to which individual. And because of that, when a supplier phones up to make an inquiry about payment on a particular invoice, it can be difficult and time-consuming for that AP team to work out where that invoice is, who's got ownership of it. And sometimes handling that exception can take hours, if not days, again, because people are out of the office, they might be on holiday, they might be on leave, they might be off sick. So it takes a lot of time to actually get the information required to handle that supplier's inquiry, and by the same token, get that invoice ready for payment as well. And because of all of these reasons, it can take a long time to process an invoice, and therefore you might be missing out on early payment discounts that you've got agreed with suppliers if you pay within your payment term period. Okay. And then finally, the invoice is filed in some kind of paper filing structure in a filing cabinet somewhere, taking up space. Typically invoices, there's a legal requirement to store those physical documents for up to 7 years before you throw them away in case there are any legal or audit reasons why you might need to retrieve those documents. So depending on the volume of your invoices per year, you might have a physical storage cost associated with storing all of that paperwork. How can process flows help? Well, the solution that I'm going to show you today is a piece of technology called ReadSoft Online, and it's a SaaS offering. So SaaS stands for Software as a Service. So it's all hosted within the cloud, which means when you implement this, there'll be no hardware costs in terms of preparing servers ready to host the software, and there's no IT cost in terms of needing a systems administrator to look after it, because it's all done in the cloud by us. And engineers in the background working to create the solution. And I'll walk you through that in a moment. Last year in 2015, we processed just under 9.8 million invoices through ReadSoft Online, and that's up 180% from 2014. So these kinds of solutions are growing rapidly. More and more people are signing up to this service every day. So the process really starts then when you receive the invoice. Just as before, you're going to receive invoices via the post, and you're going to receive invoices attached to emails. Now, obviously, you'll still need to open the post and scan your invoices, but you can scan those on network scanners or desktop scanners and put them on a kind of shared area where you can automatically upload those documents into our solution. Okay, there's a module called ReadSoft Online Connect, and effectively when you run that, it will monitor a hot folder, and then when an invoice is scanned, it'll upload it straight into the cloud. With regards to the electronic invoices received via email, you absolutely will not have to print those anymore. What we'll do is we use IMAP and MAPI to connect to email servers. If you haven't got one already, we would recommend that you set up a dedicated email address, like accounts payable at whatever your domain is. And then when your suppliers send in those invoices to that address, we'll simply pick them up and process them. Okay, so there's no need to print and scan them. There will be occasions within your business, I'm sure, where even if you notify your suppliers to use this dedicated email address, you will still get them going directly to individuals within your business. All that means is that they simply need to forward that email to the shared email address, and we'll pick it up from there. Now, just to put your mind at ease, if the same invoice comes in to two different people and they both forward it on, we have got a facility in here to check for duplicate invoices, so there's no chance that we could pay the same invoice twice. So we've got that security measure in there, and I'll show you that in a moment. Once we've uploaded the invoice into the cloud, we use intelligent OCR technology to capture all of the information from the invoice. So OCR stands for optical character recognition, and all that means is we're reading all of the character words and text on the page and doing something intelligent with it. So we're capturing who the supplier is, we're capturing the invoice number, the dates, the line item detail, and the amount fields, so that we can A, understand how we can route this document for authorization and coding, but B, how we push all of that data into the ERP system at the back end as well. We securely store the invoices in the document repository at the end of the process, or we can actually pass that information and have you download a PDF copy of the invoice so that you can put it into some other kind of system. If you're already using a document management system, or your ERP system supports the importation of image files, we can have you download it offline as well. Once we've extracted all of the data and we've stored it in the repository, we can automatically route these invoices for coding and authorization. So in the first instance, one role might be that someone in the accounts team looks at an invoice and decides how to code it. So they assign it nominal codes and cost centers, or any of the coding ID that you're currently doing in your ERP system. And then based on that information, we can route it out to individuals within the business so they can check it and authorize it before it can be paid. Now, you can route that based on the coding information. So for example, you route it as a particular cost center, the software will know to route it to that manager's cost center, sorry, that cost center's line manager to check it and authorize it. Alternatively, you might decide to do it on the price of that invoice, the gross amount. So for example, you might have someone who's got an authorization limit up to £1,500. Above that, you've got someone with a limit of 3,000. Above that, you've got a limit of 10. You know, that's completely customizable. And I'll show you later how you can actually manage your users, and you can define that matrix yourself. So then obviously once it's authorized, we can then push the invoice into the invoice data into the ERP system so that you can then pay those invoices. And we actually have direct integration with all the big common ERP systems. So today I'm going to show you integration with SageLine 50, but all of the common ones like SAP, Sun Systems, Dynamics, we've got connectors that allow us to directly push information into those ERP databases. And that's purely going to come down to your preference. Some companies don't allow direct integration with the ERP system, so in that scenario we can just download a data file, perhaps that might be a CSV file or an XML file, that you can then write an import routine to import it into your ERP system. So what we're saying here is we're flexible as to how we integrate with these ERP systems. That link is two-way, so I've already spoken about pushing data into the ERP so you can pay the invoices, but we also need to take some feeds of data from your ERP system in order to do some work in ReadSoft Online. So first and foremost, that's your supplier database, and then also when necessary, we can also accept feeds containing your PO data, which we'll come on to later. And then the last thing I want to mention here is reporting. So what you can generate from within the system is kind of an accrual report, so that a month end, when you've got your reports from your ERP system detailing how much you've actually paid out, you can actually generate an Excel report from Readsoft Online, detailing all of the invoices that are currently in the business but haven't yet been authorized. So they've been validated that they are an invoice, but they haven't been authorized, therefore the data hasn't been pushed into the ERP system. So it enables you to do some kind of forecasting financially about invoices that are pending. So one of the benefits of our solution, we've already discussed that you won't need to print invoices anymore, so there's a reduced time and print cost there. We've calculated on average, customers who adopt Readsoft Online get an ROI in approximately 6.5 months. We reduce manual effort and increase productivity. So for example, we're reducing manual indexing, we're reducing paper shuffling, we're reducing the time it takes to handle supplier queries. With reporting and being able to have a real-time status view of where every invoice is in this process, we've improved control and visibility. We're reducing the time it takes to from receipt of an payment, so therefore you should now start qualifying for your early payment discounts where applicable. We provide direct integration to the ERP where you allow us to, so there's no need for you to write custom import routines or any kind of API calls. They're all configured out of the box. We allow for growth, so as your invoice volumes go up by year, it means that you don't have to acquire additional staff in your AP teams because our software will handle that extra volume for you without the need for those extra staff members. Following on from that, we have reduced late, duplicate or fraudulent payments. We reduce your storage costs because now everything is stored electronically. It means that you can get rid of the copies that you are receiving via paper that you're scanning. And therefore you don't need storage areas within your office to handle those filing cabinets. And it means also that no invoice is lost or forgotten. So because you have visibility over every single invoice that's in the department at this moment in time, there's no chance of losing them. Okay, so let's have a look at the software then. I'm going to log into the Readsoft Online portal. The first thing you'll notice is we get an overview of where everything is in the system. So at the moment, I've got three invoices that are in the cloud ready to be verified. So that means that it's OCR'd the data, and it's just presenting it to me to check it. We've got two ready for authorization and coding, and then we've just got a total amount there of how many invoices are in process. We've got a tabular view across the top here. Now, for demonstrations, it's much, much easier for me to log in as one particular user who has rights to process an invoice at every stage along this process. However, in reality, these processes will be broken down into different user groups and roles within your business. So even though I'm doing every step, in reality, you could break these down so that different roles are doing these steps. And I'll explain that as we go along. So the first tab here is upload. So I've already mentioned the Readsoft Online connector, and that's a service that runs in the background that will automatically upload emails from your file share or pull them in from email automatically. But you also get this functionality where you can browse to a location. So let's say, for example, you've got some invoices on your desktop here. I can just select those documents. They'll be uploaded. As soon as I hit start, they'll be uploaded into the cloud and will run intelligent OCR on them. So once that's complete, we then come to the verification stage. So I've got three invoices in this queue. If I open up the first one, what this stage is for really is to check the data that the software has captured to make sure it's right before we move it on to the next stage. Now, this process is intelligent, and what happens here is in the first instance, it recognizes the telephone number and the VAT registration number. And from there, it should create a unique match to your supplier database. So we've already taken that from your ERP system and uploaded that into the cloud. We match to the supplier, and in this case, that's a supplier called Spark Minda. And the software will look in the background to see if it's seen this kind of invoice before from that supplier. And if it hasn't, it'll capture most of the data, if not all of it. But it'll present it to a user and say, okay, this is the first time I've seen this supplier invoice. You need to check that I've got all the data correct, and if I haven't, tell me where I've got it wrong. So what the user would do is select a field that it hasn't got correct, and then just double-click the value on the page, and not only will that populate that field, it will learn from it. So the next time it sees a supplier invoice from that same supplier, it will know where to look because it will know which field the user selected last time. Now, the OCR kind of gives you a head start on that. So before that occurs, what it's doing is to find the invoice number. It looks for the word invoice number and any variation on that, so document number, reference number. It'll abbreviate number to num and no and all of that kind of thing. And then wherever it finds it, it knows to look to the right of it or underneath it, because they're the two most common places it's likely to be. Okay, and that's the same for all of these other fields. So it will look for date, it will look for column headings for line items, and it will check for subtotal and total due for the amount fields down here. Now it is checking that the invoice is valid. Okay. Now we don't, for obvious reasons, we don't want to accept false positives. And by false positives, I mean a character that it thinks it's got correct, but it isn't. So for example, if it's a poor quality printed invoice and it reads an 8 as a 3, well, we check here that quantity times unit price equals total amount for that line. We check that all lines add up to net value, and we check net plus VAT plus delivery equals the gross amount. So if anything doesn't add up, it'll instantly tell you which line it is or which header field it is, so that you can go in and check it and correct it very quickly before you push it through to the next stage. Okay. Historically speaking, we have also an on-premise version of the Retoff Capture engine, and that comes with a module called Optimize. And what Optimize does is it allows you to fine-tune supplier templates where they persistently fail to extract some piece of data. Now, in the example I'm about to give you, the invoice number on most invoices is usually numeric. So when Retoff reads a character in the invoice number field, it generally assumes that it's going to be a numeric field. So let's say a particular supplier sends in an invoice, but their invoice number always starts with INV and then a six-digit string, and therefore it's always reading the first character as a 1 instead of an I. Well, in the on-premise solution, what you would do is you would go into the optimized module and you'd put a regular expression in there to say, actually, the first three characters will always be alpha. And then what you'll find is it will actually capture INV and then the six-digit string. Well, with Retoft Online, we've taken that manual task away from you. So we now offer that as a service. So if there are any items of data on an invoice that consistently don't get picked up, we can actually raise a case. So if I click that button on the toolbar there, what you'll see is a predefined list of common problems. For example, unrecognized supplier, incorrect field suggestion, etc. But in the scenario I've just described, I'm going to select validation issue. And what I'm going to put in here is a note. So I'm going to tell them invoice number always starts with alpha INV. Okay, and then what I would do is hit send. Now I'm not going to do that in this case because I don't want to create work for somebody in the background. But once you hit send, that raises a ticket in our help desk system, and an engineer will log on to the cloud and update the SparkMinder template based on your feedback that you've put into that box. Okay, so to summarize all of that, the software will learn as it goes along based on your pointing and clicking around the screen, but where it runs into difficulty, and that is a rare occasion, you can raise feedback and raise a ticket within the system so that someone in the background will fix a template for you. So within 2 days, the next time a SparkMinder invoice comes in, it will apply those rules to it. Okay. So let's just look at the layout of this screen then. So we've got the header fields here on the right. So we've got the buyer information, the supplier information, all of the header fields. We have a traffic light system here. So green means it's seen this type of invoice before and it's confident it's got the value correct. Yellow means it's a mandatory field that's actually missing. So in this case, delivery note is a mandatory field. However, delivery note number doesn't actually appear on this document. So that might be a good use for feedback to say, okay, delivery note never appears on this invoice, therefore we need to make it hidden for this type of supplier. We have the amount fields down here, it's got all that correct, and down the bottom here we have line item total. On the right here we have some more tabs. If we look at information, we can see kind of metadata associated with the file for this particular invoice. So we can see the unique ID that Retoft Online gives it, we can see the original file name, we can see who the customer is, we can see when it was received, okay, and we can see the status of that particular document. If we look at the attachment tab, what we can actually do here is add additional documentation to be related to this particular invoice. So let's say, for example, you've got an email trail between you and the supplier or you and other people internally. If you hit add document, you can add that email, or it might be a statement or any other kind of document, Word document. They'll be stored here and linked to this particular invoice. So if you've done some work around this particular document, you can upload that here, and anybody else looking at this particular invoice will see all of those attachments as well. Then we have a comments tab, and this just allows you to freeform text. So you might put in here called supplier today, and you might summarize your action for that particular call. And again, if you're not in the office when the supplier phones up next time, anybody else searching for this document can see it. They can see your notes on it, and it just avoids duplication of work, and it means you're not running around unnecessarily trying to solve something that somebody else has taken action for. And then we have the history tab, which is a full audit trail of when the document come in, what system tasks have been run against it, what user tasks have been run, et cetera, et cetera. So auditors love this tool. They can they have access to your invoices. They can have a look at the invoice. They can see a full audit trail from receipt right through to payment. So if I go back to my tabular view across the top here, the verify stage that we've just seen really could be done by anybody. It doesn't have to be an AP function. We have some customers who have their administration and secretarial team upload invoices and do the data entry. Okay, it's completely up to you how you do it. But the next stage is the approval stage. Now, this, what I'm going to show you now is coding and authorizing an invoice, but in reality, you could split that out into two different stages as well if you want. So in the first instance, you could have all invoices go to the AP team for coding, and then based on that information, you could then route it for authorization. It's completely up to you. So that's the interface here. From this point onwards, you can send out email notifications to users or user groups when they've got work to do, because obviously some people might only have to authorize two invoices a week. It's not really feasible for them to remember to log in every day and see if they've got work to do. So we'll actually send them email notifications when documents are assigned to them, and they'll just click a link. It'll take them straight into the cloud, and they can do the tasks that they're assigned. So in this case down here, it looks pretty similar to the verify view. We've got all our fields on the right. We've got our line item details down the bottom. But what I'm really interested here is the accounting tab. Okay, so I need to assign each line to a cost center or project. And what I can do here is actually configure drop-down lists. And again, this is another way that we integrate with your ERP system. So we'll take a snapshot of how you code invoices currently in your ERP, and we'll replicate that here. So in this scenario, all I want to do is assign it to the Lab 1 cost center project 1002. Okay, and then once I hit approve, that can then route it to that specific cost center manager to authorize. But as I said earlier, in this case, I'm doing both stages. So I would just hit authorize invoice there. And then we come to storage. So once the invoice has been authorized, as I said earlier, we can send that feed onto straight into your ERP system. And there are two ways we can kind of store the invoices. One is to keep them in the cloud. So let's say, for example, you want to search for a particular invoice. You can start keying that information in here, and it will automatically filter down to invoices that start with those types of numbers. And if I want to view any of these documents, I'll just hit the I, and I can see the invoice. And again, all of these tabs, so any attachments, the full document history, any comments that have been written and stored against this document. The other way is to store it directly within your ERP system or existing repository. Now, for this part of the demo, I'm going to show you SageLine 50, but as I said before, we integrate with many, many different types of ERP. So if I go to the suppliers tab and just change the view here and go into the SparkMinder as a supplier, what we have here is a memo tab, and here are the invoices that we've received for that particular supplier. Now in this case, we haven't actually downloaded the document to store in Sage. We've just stored a shortcut that will take us, it'll pass the URL to your browser and open that document directly from the cloud. Okay, so it's a real-time link. So that's the process end to end. What I'd like to show you now is the admin function. So if I log in as an admin user, as part of delivery, you will be given an admin area to your website. Now, I'm an admin to this entire pre-sale site, but effectively, when you're logging in, all you would see is your customers tab. So Colour Scheme Limited is a pre-sales company that we've set out purely for demonstration. So that's all you'll see when you log in. You'll have a user management section where you can set up your own users and groups and define what kind of access they would have. So whether they should be able to verify, whether they should be able to code, whether they'd be able to authorize. You can upload information relating to all of the different buyers within your organization. And again, what kind of things you want to log in the audit trail. But the key thing here to remember is the reporting aspect. So here we have our accrual report. If I hit generate, what that will do is that will just show me all invoices that have been received but haven't, that have been verified, so the data on it has been verified, but hasn't actually yet been posted into the ERP system for payment. And what I can actually do is hit the download button, and that'll just ask me where I want to save it, and that'll create a CSV file, and then from there I can distribute it to anyone that needs to see it. We also have a document processing report, and what that does is that will just show you how many documents have been run through Readsoft Online in a specific amount of time. So it enables you to monitor how many invoices you're receiving, how quickly they're going through, and what stage they are in within the process. And again, you just have a document volumes report, which is a similar sort of thing, but it just gives you total numbers of invoices processed through the system. What you also have down here is your master data. So this is where all of your information is stored relating to your cost centers, currencies, departments, GL accounts, projects, your supplier database, and your tax codes. So through that Readsoft Online Connect module that I described earlier, we can pull that straight from the ERP system, or alternatively, you'd create an export from your ERP system of various different text files, and we'd use that Readsoft Online Connector module to upload that data here so that we can use it as I've already shown you. So that's a bit of a whirlwind tour of Readsoft Online. I'd just like to talk about now how we approach releasing new versions and service packs and things like that. So with Readsoft Online, once you subscribe to use this service, you'll get a new release about every 10 months, and that's included. There are no charges for releasing new features. You just get everything as it comes out. And as I say, the release period for that is approximately every 10 months. Within the next release, which is due this month, we're migrating everything into HTML5. Now, currently, it does use Silverlight, which, as you may know, browsers are now reducing or even, in some cases, removing support for Silverlight. Well, this month, we're actually releasing the HTML client, so it'll work on any browser because it's not dependent on having anything installed on your actual workstations. There's also going to be line item matching and PO flipping capabilities, and what that means is if you upload your PO data from your ERP system, it means that we can match against it. So let's say, for example, you've got a 10-line PO, and the invoice comes in and it's got 10 lines on it, and it will look for, you know, part numbers and quantities and unit prices that match, and it uses some fuzzy logic to account for ones where the part number is different. But let's say, for example, it can match 8 out of those 10 lines. It'll assign those 10 lines as green to tell you that it's matched, but the two that don't match, it'll flash up yellow to say, okay, I'm not sure about this one, it doesn't match the PO. And what you can actually do from there is bring up the PO line item data and tell the software which lines they actually match to. So for example, you might have ordered something at £10 per item, but when the invoice comes in, you're billed for £15 per item. Well, that will get flagged up at that stage so that you can handle that as an exception. Now, it might be you just hit approve because you're going to pay it, or it might be that you call the supplier and work out why you're being charged more than was originally quoted, as an example, and resolve that before you actually push that invoice through for payment. Okay. And with this latest release as well, there's also improved algorithms in the background for capturing different types of line items. So typically, at the moment, historically speaking, you've only been able to capture one table format in the middle of an invoice, but with the latest release that's coming, we're allowing for multiple different table types. So if you've got two or more different types of table on that invoice, we'll actually be able to capture the data from both. Now, once the new release is available, we'll be running another webinar in approximately 8 weeks' time, where we'll be demonstrating those features. So that's everything end to end. Thank you very much for attending today. If you would like more information, please do get in touch. You could email us at sales@processflows.co.uk, or you can call us on 01962-835-033, and please quote ReadSoft Online Webinar in any correspondence.